In 1992 was the first time I ever touched a computer, and I immediately began studying programming. But for several years before that I played a lot of games on the NES and the Famicom. And in NES games, one of the most fascinating things to me were the password generators. I am Bisqwit, and in this series we are going to study how old games generated their passwords. The test subject for today's episode is Rocoman 3. Known as Mega Man 3 in the Western countries. Compared to Mega Man 2, the grid of this game is slightly larger and there are dots of two different colors. Let's dissect the problem. As usual, the password encodes whether any or all of the 8 robot masters have been beaten. There are also items, Rush Jet, Rush Marine and E-Tanks. However, Rush Jet comes automatically with Needleman and Rush Marine comes automatically with Shadowman, so they can be crossed out. But here's where it gets more complicated. After you beat the 8 robot masters, the password records whether you have also beaten Breakman or not. And if you have done that, there's 4 additional bosses. All of these are recorded in the password. Let's summarize it up. The 8 robot masters each are either beaten or not beaten. This means 1 bit of data per boss. The same goes for Breakman and for the 4 extra bosses. The number of energy tanks can be from 0 to 9, and expressing this number requires 4 bits of storage. This would appear to bring the total amount of data to 17 bits, but that's not true, for you see, it is impossible to beat Breakman without first beating all 8 robot masters. So we have 256 different states for the first 8 bosses. Beating Breakman adds 1, so now the number is 257. After Breakman has been beaten, the 4 extra bosses come up for 16 different combinations. Since we already counted 1, that leaves 15, bringing the total to 272. And finally this number is multiplied by 10 for the 10 possible E-Tank counts. Therefore the game would only require about 12 bits to encode all these states. Much less than the 17 we got earlier. But I decoded this password system before I knew anything about bits and logarithms, so let's follow the methodology that the 13-year-old me used back in 1991. We start with a blank game state. The game generates this password. Rather unexpected. Next, we compare with the full house password. There doesn't seem to be anything in common with this too. Well, at least we know from this that the password system is different from Mega Man 2. In Mega Man 2, the number of dots was always 9. Here it varies. It seems to suggest that each additional thing that you have completed adds a dot on the table. But there are only 8 dots here, while the number of robots to beat was 13. And what was that one dot in the blank password? Was it an E-Tank indicator? Working on that assumption, I collected E-Tanks and requested a password after each additional E-Tank. Every time there was just one dot, and it changed depending on the number of E-Tanks. I also tried entering passwords where the dot is somewhere else, but the game wouldn't accept any of those. However, changing the color of that dot did nothing. The game didn't care about the color of the dot. Next I did the same with the robot masters, and I noticed that beating each boss individually adds one red dot somewhere on the table. The locations of these dots were independent of the E-Tanks, unlike in Mega Man 2. You could change the E-Tank number freely without the rest of the password being changed. So far exactly half of the free spots in the grid were accounted for. Next I tried combining these dots, and I noticed the most curious property. Some combinations would work, while some would not. This was perplexing. I noticed that the absolute largest number of bosses you could beat with this table is 4. There is no way you could add the 5th dot. The game just wouldn't accept it, and only some combinations of 4 bosses would work. Having drawn a dead end, I tried an alternative approach, changing the color. For exactly half of the bosses, changing the dot color from red to blue did nothing at all. The game didn't care. But what about the other half? For the other half, changing the dot from red to blue meant beating 2 bosses. One blue dot means that 2 bosses were beaten. This consistent behavior carried also to Breakman and the 4 extra bosses. At this point, the password scheme was complete. A purpose has been found for every slot in the grid. Some dots are red, but the game doesn't care if you enter them in blue, here indicated in purple color, and others have a meaning that depends whether it's red or blue. I am Bisqwit, stay tuned for the next time when we delve deeper into the rabbit hole.